Welcome back. We are very excited. For over a decade, our next guest has been helping change the way people see and appreciate their own bodies. She's a best-selling author, documentary maker, and now our 2023 Australian of the Year.
It's an issue that affects practically every woman and girl that I know.
I wasn't tall enough, I wasn't skinny enough, I wasn't blonde enough, I just wasn't enough.
For years, society has been telling women to be beautiful, as if that's the most important thing they can be.
After I had my three children, I ended up hating my body.
So I trained hard, and you know what? I'm standing there in my perfect body, and I'm not happy.
Too much sacrifice, too much time, too much obsession, and it's just not worth it.
Michaela.
I don't want my daughter to feel the same way, so I'm going to go find some answers. Why do so many people hate their bodies, and what can we do about it?
Brilliant.
What a woman. We are pleased to say that Taryn joins us now. Taryn, congratulations. It's so amazing.
Aussie of the Year.
Thank you.
Has it sunk in yet?
No, of course not. I'm on an hour's sleep. I'm not sure when it will sink in, but I have to say I woke up this morning after that 60 minutes and just thought, I am so excited to have the attention of the nation to talk about what is a very important subject, body image, and take it from, you know, my last decade of work. It's at times people have sort of thought, oh, it's hashtag love your body. But no, of course it's not. It's so much more serious, and we're about to have that dialogue.
Okay, we're about to, but before we get to that dialogue, can I ask you, after all your work, after every ounce of blood, sweat and tears that you have given for this cause, what did the moment feel like?
Surreal. It was an out-of-body experience, and I said that in my speech. You know, I'm standing there in front of, well, the nation and a live audience, and of course the Prime Minister just metres away, thinking, you know, get this one right, Taryn. but it was, look, you know, dear, don't stuff it up. But it was a real honour. I'm really humbled, and I'm going to be on a high for quite some time, maybe even 12 months.
Well, something makes me think you were never going to stuff it up, Taryn. Yeah. But, hey, you know, your message all this time has been about loving your body and embracing the way you look, but it's something that so many of us find so challenging.
Yeah, everyone does. I mean, I did. I hated my body. I learned to love it. And honestly, it felt like winning the golden ticket. And I just wanted every Australian and every person on the planet to understand the power and the joy that comes from embracing your body. And in this country, 70% of Australian school children consider body image to be their number one concern. Mm-hmm. And we also know that kids with body dissatisfaction are 24 times more likely to be depressed and have anxiety. So if you put those two stats together, we've got a big problem. Let's not solve it at the end. Let's prevent it. And we've got the solutions. It's embrace kids.
It is, and also, you know, it's about the people you have around you and the messaging. Like, for example, like I could easily have a six-pack, but my wife loves my little pot. Like, she just loves it. And she finds it quite sexy.
Yeah, love a little pot.
So it's about that kind of messaging. From an early, just made that up, obviously. But it's about that messaging from an early age, isn't it? What are you going to do with the time? Because 12 months will go really quickly.
It will.
What do you want to be standing here next year on this day saying?
Look, we want to reach 1 million Australian school children with the message of embrace, which is to move, nourish, respect and enjoy your body. I would like to fundraise for my next documentary, which is Embrace Men. And I'd like to do it by not running a marathon this time. That's how I raised the money to make Embrace Kids. I've done two marathons, so if anyone wants to help me, let's make that film. We are ready to go. We just need the money to do it. But really, in schools as well, we've got $1 million.
Yeah.
You can get that.
Karl, are you offering?
I'd rather do that than run a marathon.
Well, this is what I'm saying.
Yeah. We'll look at it.
But I tell you what we're going to do as well. We're going to get into schools with the curriculum that we've created for kids and disseminate from the top down. We're going to get this right, Australia.
Worthy recipient of the Australian of the Year.
Absolutely.
Good on you, Taryn. We can't be prouder of you. And good luck in the next year.
It'll make a difference, that's for sure.
It sure will. Plenty
Thank
more
you, of today.
Well, the word hero often gets thrown around, but our next guest truly deserves the title, taking out the local hero award at last night's Australian of the Year ceremony.
Amar Singh is the founder of disaster aid and food relief charity Turbans for Australia. And we're pleased to say he joins us now. Amar, congratulations.
Yay.
How wonderful.
Hey, thanks for having me, guys.
It's so nice to see you. How do you feel being honoured?
Absolutely amazing. You know, it was a great night last night, finally be able to enjoy among so many wonderful Australians. Our PM was there, Governor General was there, so many heroes right around Australia and our families. So it's been an amazing night and last couple of days. My motto was simple, you know, eat, sleep and smile.
Yeah. but what a good motto.
You do that and you live it. Yeah. But what is it? I mean, you and your story and what you've given to our community. Give us a sense of the pride you felt inside.
Look, it's what's needed to be done. Our people suffer when floods, disasters hit, and we shouldn't sit back. We have to do something to make a positive change in our society, because as a country, as a society, we need to be in it together, you know, and we need to work towards a productive outcomes for these disasters, and we can't leave anyone behind. That's just not us as Australians. So when the disaster's in regional towns, we want to man up and go there and help out. You know, it's absolutely amazing to tell those regional Australians that it's okay, you know, this is only a short-term thing. We're here and we care about you guys.
Emma, you exude such joy just looking at you. I mean, there's so much warmth that radiates from you, and that's incredible. You know, you founded the charity after experiencing racism and insults, but what is it that made you want to give back to the community and be the beautiful person you are?
Oh, look, giving back is everyone's moral responsibility. People give back in different ways, you know. So what can we do to make our society better? Give back. And that's what we do. On a small thing that started many years ago, now it's become to me being named Australian local hero. It's absolutely humbling, but I still love doing what I do. Sunday, I'm back to packing hampers, handing them out at our Clyde warehouse.
Did you have a quiet moment, though? Did you have a bit of reflection on the achievement?
Look, it's a reflection every day to be able to go back home to a warm bed and a roof over our heads. And for people in Northern Rivers who still are living out of caravans, I absolutely, you know, feeling in the gut that why are we still suffering and why is it still going through the... Look at the bushfires. People are still struggling through that and COVID. So we need to do is elevate our people out of these disasters so nobody's left behind. But, you know, you're right. It's a wonderful feeling to be named Australian of the Year, and it's such a huge honour.
Yeah, good on you. All the work that you do,
so
we really
inspiring.
Appreciate it. We love telling your story, and congratulations to you and your family. Appreciate it.
Thanks for joining us
How
this
good.
Morning.
Don't get any ideas, fella. Steve Liebmann, everyone. Morning. Lovely to see you. We're going to take a little trip down memory lane before
talk
to you. Yeah, but for 20 years, our next guest sat in this very seat, welcoming Australia to a brand new day.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Steve Liebmann, and thank you for joining us on this, the first edition of the National Today Show.
I'm Sue Kellaway, and I'm delighted to be here. And, Steve, what a start we have to the show.
We're going to be busy today, Sue. The spectacular history-making fourth trip by the American Space Shuttle has just begun, and we'll have a full cover of that for you this morning. And our special studio guest today will be the Federal Treasurer, John Howard, talking on, of all things, taxes.
Mm-hmm. There's nothing more certain than death and taxes.
I've read your report, and it seems to me that what you're saying is this, that there's little new in it, that criticism of the taxation department's unfair, that avoidance and evasion schemes didn't become widespread until after 1978, and now with new laws everything's okay. Do you think the Australian public is going to buy that?
Heather and Scotland the brave, and woe betide anybody, like the taxman, who stands between the Scots and dreams of home. They're now preparing to march on Canberra.
Mike Hamilton reporting. I bet you didn't know all that information about kilts before.
No, I didn't. I was just trying to imagine what it's going to be like when all those swirling kilts converge on Parliament House.
Have you ever worn one?
You're joking.
That's something I'd like to see.
Really?
Will you do it?
No. Don't hold your breath.
Jeez, some heavy...
Still no kilt today.
It's just cool me down. Steve Liebmann's extraordinary career has spanned an incredible six decades, and for that alone, he's a fitting recipient of an Australia Day honour, and we're lucky enough to have him in the studio. A round of applause for Steve Liebmann again. Lovely to have you back
Thank
in
you.
Your home. It's your wonderful. Rightful seat, and congratulations.
Thank you very much. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. I'm very chuffed. I'm still getting my head around it, but I'm really honoured.
When you found out?
When did I find out? About a week ago. They let you know and they say, don't say anything to anyone. You're sworn to secrecy and there you go.
And how did you mark it at the time? What were your first thoughts?
I was overwhelmed, really. You know, it's... You know,
big deal.
It is, and I'm very honoured to have received the award. Yeah.
Did it make you reflect on your own achievements when you thought about it? Sat back and thought about it.
I guess you do. I mean, it's not bad for a kid from Cooma.
Yeah.
Which is where it all began for me back in 1957 when I sort of fell into radio, and that's where and you would appreciate this. That's where I learnt my trade. And from then on, it was a progression from country radio, regional radio, city radio, television, and then the Today Show.
And you're a remarkable presenter. I think, pound for pound, one of the best in the world.
That's nice of you to say.
I grew up watching and then admiring you in the field. And for me to have taken over your seat as well... I also struggle a little bit with the tight pants these days, crossing my legs.
I like your fashion coordination.
No, that's you guys are matching
blue
today. I like it. Open shirt.
An honour, the most tremendous honour to take over from.
I remember
you.
That.
Yeah, yeah.
Early 2005.
I was not ready. And I think you
Green
saw
has.
That. I was like 30.
No.
What have they done?
I remember that because you were based in LA. It long time ago.
What? Do you miss it at all?
No.
Yeah. Do you want to think
you
about it?
You did it for long enough. I mean,
you know, I did it for just over 20 years.
Yeah.
I never considered it work. Mm. The alarm would go at 3 a.m. And I mean, I know it goes for you guys about the same time.
Yeah.
But I can honestly say there was never a day that the alarm went and I thought, I don't want to go to work. It really wasn't work. It isn't. Well, I don't think it's
fun, isn't it? And this is the thing. I'll let you in on a secret, Levo. Earlier, before when we knew you were coming in, Karl said to me, I've got 4 more years until I can break his record. He's coming for you.
Well, I didn't say that. Why would you reveal that to Levo?
No, they were great years, but I don't miss it. And I think in many respects I saw the best of it.
Yeah. I don't know about that. It's evolving, it's changing.
It's changed.
I'm never going to argue with you.
No.
Because, I mean, you also did have, even in those days, a lot of fun. I remember the story about Tracy at the Logies people and folks at home. Can you just tell that quickly? Would you mind?
Tracy at the Logies?
Yeah. Remember when she got locked out of her room?
Yeah. And fortunately, there was a big newspaper.
She got locked out of
on
her
hand.
Out of her room
did
naked.
It look a bit like this?
And she had a copy of the Australian.
That's right.
She wrapped around herself.
No, I was very lucky. Yeah. I mean, I had great partners.
Yeah.
Sue Kellaway when we launched in 82. And then Lizzie.
Beautiful Lizzie.
And then Trace for 9 years.
Mm. Yeah.
And you know, as you're finding out, that relationship becomes a professional marriage.
Mm.
And it's got to work. And in my case, it worked.
Yeah. Well, we're still basically going through the
courting
phase.
I want a divorce.
Yeah.
Certainly.
I've got a new co-host, Karl.
Not another one.
How much better is this?
Hey, no.
Gee, she slipped over the back fence quickly, didn't she, eh?
I don't like this.
Actually, I like it too.
Bye, Karl.
No, okay. Well, there you go.
Oh, boy.
Out with the old and...
Exactly.
But you're enjoying it.
Go on.
I am enjoying it. It's a lot of fun. And it's... No, in all seriousness, even though I've divorced Karl now, he's an incredible co-host. And you do learn a lot about a partnership. I mean...
My word. It really becomes a professional marriage and it has to work and you cannot fool the audience out there. They can tell if you're faking it.
Yeah.
So, you know, that's very important.
What's your analysis so far?
I think you're doing pretty well. And
did you hear that, Karl?
I like the way you keep him honest.
Yeah. Someone has to, right?
Yeah. No, I think it's great.
All right. Well, Levo, we know you're a professional, so over to you.
Oh, really?
Yeah, go for it.
Still to come on today from one legend to another. The Australian of the Year is live right here talking about all her plans for 2023 and it's a great decision.
Levo, what a legend.
He was just ad-libbing. You have not lost it. Incredible.
Thank you.